Well, Christchurch's most colourful businessman has pleaded for the city councillors to keep car parking at the back of their minds as the long-term plan is turned into a reality. But what solutions would work? Here's Marcus Gibbs.
Car parking. Nobody likes paying for it, but it's crucial for the survival of Christchurch's central city businesses.
Parking is critical for central city's economic viability, not just in the future, but right now.
Speaking at the first of the Christchurch City Council's draft long-term plan hearings, flamboyant businessman Anthony Goff spoke passionately about his city.
This is an exciting time for the central city. Despite the gloom that can often be reported by the media, commercial momentum is returning. Our members are essentially the pioneers. They have the faith in the city and are excited by its future.
But Goff says car parking is needed and the council needs to take lessons from his experimentation with property development.
We think there is an opportunity there for you to have outside providers. You're short of capital, whether you like it or not. Just like I personally am short of capital in the terrace project, and I've had to sell some of that off in order to be able to finish it. Council needs to be doing the same thing.
The sites of many earthquake-damaged buildings have been cleared and replaced with car parks recently, but these are temporary, and the Central City Business Association is desperate for more car parks to satisfy shoppers.
It is a major concern for us moving forward, not just our hotel, but all of the hospitality in this long-term parking.
Since the Ibis Hotel reopened 2.5 years ago, more than 170,000 people have stayed in the hotel. However, with only 22 car parks in the hotel's basement, the Ibis's customers are struggling to find parks.
It's in our top three of comments from all guests about the lack of parking in the city. And that's now, that's not in the future when we've got the Justice Precinct with, I understand, no car parking available, with the building across the road from us opening later this year, with again no parking for any visitors.
Goff says it's been too long and the council needs to act now.
But we've been 5 years and there's not one public car park building being started in the central city. We can't wait any longer.
He wants to encourage more people into the central city to help the businesses thrive and says car parks are the answer. All the council has to do is provide an incentive.
A period where the first hour of council off-street parking is free would, in our view, be a great start.
The shortage has already reached a critical level, and as key developments are built and open for business, it's only going to get worse.
So we strongly recommend that the council urgently progresses the process underway with the private sector to explore permanent parking.
Within the next few years, thousands of office workers are expected to be in the central city, but the question is, where will they park? Goff's solution is for the Canterbury Earthquake Recovery Authority to use some of the east or south frame for parking until the land is needed for commercial and residential development.
I don't think it matters a hoot whether they're owned by the council or private sector. The important thing is to provide car parking. I think there's an opportunity for both public and private ownership of car parking.
This isn't the first time the contentious issue of car parking has come up for discussion. The council needs to replace two of its parking buildings and within the cost-sharing agreement has already agreed to pay $70 million to fund new off-street parking facilities. The council has already made a deal with the Carter Group to replace a 534-space parking building on the site of the Crossing car park, and in March, the City Council started seeking expressions of interests for firms interested in being involved in funding, building, owning and operating parking buildings in the central city. Marcus Gibbs, CTV News.